Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to our very first part of D2, a very rare survival horror game that came out for the Dreamcast. There are two prior games, D and Enemy Zero. D released for the PlayStation, and Enemy Zero released for the Sega Saturn. Anyway, let's watch the opening movie. It's only a disc 4 for some reason.
Excuse me, miss. You dropped this. Wow, sure is a pretty compact. You wouldn't want to lose it. It's from your mother, isn't it, Laura? By the way, were you having a nightmare or something? You were mumbling and talking in your sleep. Are you all right? Well, I don't fly too well myself. Oh, here. Oh.
Shut up. I said, shut up. The final destroyer, the great shadow, is coming. Pray and celebrate the coming of the final destroyer, our lord, the shadow. The final destroyer has come. The shadow has arisen.
The final destroyer. Shadow, the final destroyer.
Shut up, I said.
Finally came to. Some days have passed since that terrible accident. But I only found you the day before yesterday. You were lying in the snow, and I brought you here. You've been asleep for 2 days, you know. I just can't figure it out. How did you manage to stay alive for 8 days? Looks like you were eating regularly, too. So strange. I found you pretty far away from the crash site. Do you remember anything? I see. I'm Kimberly. Kimberly Fox. I'll talk to you more later. You must be tired. Seems like you were having a lot of nightmares, too.
But yeah, though, folks, if you try to shoot him, it'll just skip to the next cutscene.
Parker. Parker Jackson. You two must be survivors of that plane crash. Are you hurt?
Don't touch me. Get out of here.
Just a minute. What do you think you're doing?
Get the hell out of here.
Wait. I haven't blossomed yet. Come on. Didn't it look like flowers were blooming from that monster? You both saw it, and there's more just like it out there. He's not the only one.
What exactly was that thing?
Who the hell knows? Some of them look like they might have been passengers from the crash. But the monsters got to them. And as you can see, they turn into...
Monsters?
Yeah. They blossom. They've turned into monsters, too.
Get out.
Look, like I said...
I'll shoot. I swear I'll shoot.
Look, unless we work together, we won't get out of here alive.
I will shoot.
All right, I'll go.
Now.
All right. I get it. But listen up. And listen good. You may be on. But there's only one way to tell whether someone's human or not. And that's by the color of their blood. Those things bleed green. But to see any blood, you've got no choice but to shoot. And you've got to do it fast because they'll be on you in a flash. We don't know much of anything yet. Should we shoot everything that looks like this creature? And what if it looks human and bleeds green? There may be monsters that bleed red for all we know. What are we supposed to do then? We don't know whether everything that looks like a monster always has green blood. Maybe some are still human inside. Maybe they can revert back to humans again. We don't have any answers. All I can say is, survive. Get out of this godforsaken place alive. Be careful, both of you. Watch your back.
I'm sorry. I wish... if I could... Damn it. I'm sorry about that. We're both in the same boat, I guess. I just don't know what to do or how to do it. Maybe that man feels the same way. Everyone who survived feels that way. They had no idea what to do. Maybe you're better off than others, not remembering anything. Hey, do you remember anything? Anything about Janny? Janny! The little girl I found you with. You were both lying there, in the snow, and you were trying to protect her. Oh, I brought you both back here. She wandered off when I wasn't looking. She may know something about you. And she may still be around here, just hiding. Maybe you could take a look outside. You won't be able to walk too far in the snow. And the area is surrounded by forest and a sheer drop, but... I'll wait here. Be careful, okay?
Finally, we can move. But yeah, long first cutscene, folks. Long first cutscene. Yeah, if you press Y and you move around the analog stick, you can find certain objects like this first aid spray. There are different first aid sprays you find throughout the game. Green restores a little bit of health. Yellow restores a moderate amount of health. And red restores all health. So, yeah. In here, you'll find a machine gun. Yeah, folks. We don't start with a handgun. We start with a fucking machine gun. Because that's how much of a badass Laura Parton is. Wonder if she's related to Dolly Parton. Nah. But yeah. We can choose to speak to Kimberly over here. First of all, I want the first aid spray. But yeah.
You really can't remember those 8 days after the crash? I wonder if Jenny was with you the whole time. Well, I'm sure it'll come back to you in time. Be careful out there.
Yeah, in case you couldn't already tell, this game is very cutscene heavy. It has a lot of story, but it's a good story. In fact, I go so far as to say this is one of my favorite stories in a video game. It's just so unique and weird, and I just absolutely love it. But yeah. Much like the movie The Thing, if your blood is green, that means you're a monster. That's the rules of this game, you know? Alright, there's some shotgun shells here. We don't have a shotgun yet, but we'll be getting one, fairly soon, I'd say. Yeah, it'll automatically select a gun for you. You're gonna home into this rabbit using the R trigger. Then you're gonna take a shot.
You think it's cool? I did too at first. But you know, I spoke with this Norwegian hunter in a tavern. He said even rabbits and mice have killer instinct. And there's no such thing in this world as absolute prey or an absolute predator. He also said that it's an energy, kind of a focused awareness that binds life together. So I guess we better stay on our guard at all times to survive. To feed the flame of instinct with the fuel of life, was the way he put it. The reason why consuming meat gives the body strength is because the urge to kill and the energy of life embodies the flesh. Or something like that. I guess what I'm trying to tell you is to eat a lot and get better soon. Come on. Aim straight and take a shot.
Alright. So this time we can actually shoot the bunny. It wouldn't let me do that before. Or maybe it just wasn't fast enough. But yeah.
Alright. You got it. That way. There's two more over there.
I hate having to kill bunnies, mainly because they're my favorite creature besides giraffes. But we need that meat, so. Bam. Alright, stand still. Little bastard. Woo! Got 4 meats in total.
Wow. You're way better than me. I think you've got what it takes to be a great hunter. You can put the game you caught in this portable cooker. It automatically cleans and cooks the meat. So you can eat whenever you're hungry. It's pretty good. Much better than stale bread. I'm gonna go get a little rest now.
And now we can finally move Laura around the open world of Canada. So yeah, for a Dreamcast game, this is pretty big. It took a total of 4 discs. And yeah, I have a physical copy of this game. It is so good. You have to play this at least once before you die, at least in my opinion. But yeah, first objective is to get to the plane. And I love these fucking zombies, dude. They're like plant zombies. I think what makes them so creepy, at least to me, is the way they breathe. The way they breathe makes it sound like they're in pain, you know? Like excruciating pain. You're gasping for air. But yeah, this game does a very good job at being bizarre and creepy. Anyway, we're gonna go head into here real quick. See what's in this old cabin. But yeah, there is a cabinet right there. We need a key for it. And there's this. Also need a key. Grab this first aid spray, though. Another one. Alright, got a good amount of first aid sprays already. Let's check this out. Yeah, you can rest in this bed to fully restore your HP. Oh yeah, I forgot to look at this photo. So the point of that cutscene was to show that Laura Parton was not a monster. You see, in this game, the rules are, if you bleed green, you're a monster. As I said before, this movie's kind of like the thing, you know, where monsters can take the shape of other humans, including people you know personally. A very creepy concept, and one that I still love to this day. Imagine if she, like, cut her hand again when she was getting the photo. Just, like, cut the other one. But, anyway. We have to go towards that plane crash. There's a sign here, but I can't really read it. I try to press the A button, nothing will happen, so. Yeah. Yeah, the plane is down here. Oh yeah, these monsters aren't too tough. Pretty easy to take care of. I mean, they should be, considering the fact you have a machine gun. But yeah. I know it sounds a bit random, but I really like Laura Parton's character design. I know she just has like a red dress and like high heels. But I don't know, it's just... It's a simple yet beautiful design, at least to me, anyway. Yeah, it's a long ways away on foot. Wonder if there's any rabbits around here, I'll give it a quick check. But yeah, if you kill some rabbits, they restore about as much health as a green first aid spray, which is very useful. And you can use as many first aid sprays and meats as you want to while you're in a battle. You don't have to wait your turn or anything. Oh man, he's right next to me. It's making me hella uncomfortable. Yeah, situation's dealt with. I also like this Tony Hawk-esque music, you know? It sounds like some kind of track you'd hear if you're in a skate shop. Kind of unfitting for a survival horror RPG, but I don't mind it one bit. Oh, you're a bird. Yeah, there's one right there. Shoot it really quickly. Ah, too far. Ah, man, I missed. That's how it goes. But yeah, though, folks, if you take a look at the map here, you'll see we're in Bacon Farm Historic Park. It's a little bit of a silly name, but whatever. It's also right next to Ruff's Lookout. Over here, we're gonna go to Tyro Golding gold mining industry later in this playthrough. And yeah, just want to show off the map real quick. Yeah, though, folks, this is where the plane crashed. This is the first place you're supposed to go to. You can even see pieces of the plane right here. Ah, finally, the tentacle monsters popped out. Yeah. Ah, he got me. Yeah, your health, you can tell how low you are in health by the color of the number. Like, you see where the number is? Well, if you're green, you're about to die. If you have a moderate amount of health, it's orange. And if you're full of health, it's red. This is supposed to be symbolic because the green blood means you're turning into a monster, whereas the red blood indicates that you're still human. Well, that's weird. Where's the entrance to the plane? Is it over here? Did I miss it? Ah, yeah, I missed it. It's right here. Yeah, definitely overshot that. But yeah. There's nothing to find here. You're just supposed to go into the plane and see all the horrific shit that's in here. Yeah, though, man. Honestly, it's kind of creepy, even by today's standards. I mean, just look at all this blood. Look at the amount of dead bodies. It's very, well, realistic, despite its polygonal graphics. That guy died reading a magazine. Probably wasn't even a good one. Yeah, though, now we're supposed to go back into the cabin, only be told to come back here. That might be a little bit later, but yeah, it's been a while since I played this game. Anywho, just gotta get on back. Hopefully no monsters will attack us, but you know monsters are gonna attack us. So this is Canada, after all. Some freaky shit happens when a plane crashes and there's, well, monsters aboard. I don't think that's just a Canada thing, I think that's just a general thing, really. Okay, so this guy you need to watch out for, because he's a tricky little bastard. You may be wondering why my health is that red right now. Well, it's because I leveled up, and whenever you level up, your health fully restores. Now, you don't get to some insane level in this game. By the time you're on disc 4, I think you're at, like, level 19, level 20. Whereas with a game like Final Fantasy, you get to, like, level 100. Or, like, Tales of Symphonia. That takes a couple playthroughs just to get to that point, though. But yeah. Ooh, there's some bunnies here. I want their meat. Ah, lost track of them. That's okay. Let's just focus on getting back to the cabin. The one that Kimberly Fox is in. My god, I never realized this, but his face is stretched on his body. It's a little bit creepy. Not the creepiest thing I've ever seen, because, you know, I've seen similar stuff, but still, a little freaky to see, even nowadays. Yeah, this game came to America in the year 2000. It came out in Japan in 1999, I think. But yeah. This was a later Dreamcast title, for sure. Oddly enough, though, Dreamcast still went strong in Japan. The last game was a shoot-em-up released in 2007. I believe the name was Karus, or something like that. I don't know, some weird name. But yeah, if you press a Y button while you're low on ammo, you can use that to, you know, reload. Yeah, though, folks, there's the cabin. We're almost there, man. Oh god, there's two of them, I think. No? Only one? Okay. That might just be my earphones, then. Home base. Nah, Kimberly's sleeping in our bed. Wake up! Please? Alright, I'm gonna talk to you now.
Hi. I guess you didn't find Jenny. Where would she be? There's nothing else around here except the stone hut. I already looked there. There's the crash site, but I don't think you should go there. You'll only see things of the brutal aftermath.
We just saw it.
The snow must have given those poor people a proper burial by now. If you are going to the stone hut, use this key to open the cabinet inside. I locked it because I didn't want the monsters to get any of the weapons in there. Be careful. I'm tired. I'm gonna rest a little bit longer.
Oh, okay. Thanks for the key. Kinda wish you gave it to us before we left. Now we gotta backtrack. Well, at any rate, folks, I think I'm going to call it there. I know most of this part was just cutscenes, but I think the next part will have some more gameplay. Until then, I will see you later.